In the upcoming months, 2K and Uninterrupted are teaming up to bring you a wide range of stories, all encompassing the need for social change. Because no matter your background, we all have the opportunity to create real and lasting change. But it has to start right now. So let's talk about what your vote can do in this election and in every election. It can affect voter suppression, educational opportunities, our healthcare systems. We can make a change. If you want to check out the voting rules in your state, visit vote.org. More Than a Vote explores the issues that are facing us in this upcoming 2020 election. I'd like to start with my story and my experiences right here in my hometown of Atlanta. So people who say their vote doesn't matter, my response is always, don't give in to the narrative. If your vote didn't matter, then why would people have fought so hard to keep you from voting? Why is there something called voter suppression? Why did it take till the 60s for poll taxes to be removed? Why did Black people have to wait for amendments to be passed in order to vote? People have been fighting to keep people of color from coming to the polls and recognizing their power for a reason. But I'm not going to give up. If I give up, then what am I saying about my future kids? What am I saying about the future of my community? We're all gonna have to step forward, put our fears to the side, not let that narrative drive us, and let the strength of our vote, of our voice, of where we are right now matter. It has to matter. My name is Maria Taylor, and I'm voting because of voter suppression and lack of educational resources. In the state of Georgia, there's a huge gap between the suburbs and the city of Atlanta. It can be that there just aren't as many computers, or you're having teachers with less experience. And these are all barriers to young kids that don't deserve it. And I think that COVID is basically just going to increase the gap that we're seeing in education, because unfortunately, African Americans have less access to high-speed internet. How can you be in a Zoom chat with your teacher if you don't have high-speed internet? Does that mean you're just not going to class? Like, these things are gonna continue to divide the range of wealth that we're able to achieve, whether or not we're gonna be able to go to college. To me, the most pressing issue has to be education, because that's gonna determine whether or not a child that's born in poverty can climb out of it. I'm from Alpharetta, Georgia, which is a suburb of Atlanta. So my mom and I went to go and vote in our state's primaries, and we saw that the line was wrapped around the library, literally from the front door all the way out through the sidewalk to the backside. We were sitting there for close to 2 hours, and we had probably moved maybe 100 feet, something like that. Like, everyone was confused. No one knew what was going on. We're all asking questions. We finally heard someone said, hey, we hear that the line is shorter at the Roswell Library. And we figured, since we've been sitting this line for 2 hours, like, look, we might as well go try somewhere else. So we get in the car, we drive about 25 minutes to the next library, and same issue. And you can see the line starting from the door and going around the parking lot and going to the back of the library. So we waited another about 3 hours. And we finally get to, you know, the front of the line, and you see that it's just basically understaffed. Everyone who was working in there, every volunteer, was a Black woman, and they're probably 50 to 60. And, you know, we keep talking about, like, who could be infected by COVID at the highest rates, and it is the African American community. They're risking their life to come and work at these polling sites, and I don't want the burden of being a volunteer to be on the 50 to 60 year old Black woman. So it's important that we, as young people who feel healthy and feel comfortable, go out there and make sure that people are able to exercise their right to vote. All told, the adventure of voting ended up taking about 6 hours. After we voted, my mom and I vowed, like, we're going to do early voting and be the first people in line as soon as the opportunity presents itself. And I know that by voting early, it'll allow me to actually volunteer on November 3rd. Wherever they need us, we'll be there. If that's just directing people into a line, I'll do that. If that's helping people actually cast their ballot, I'll do that. But either way, I just want to be, you know, a smiling, positive force, making sure that everyone feels safe and has the right to vote.